Oh, thank you guys. Durango is awesome. Just because we're the whitest town around, do we have to act like it? I flew out of Durango recently. There's yoga in the airport now. I walked in, there's a bunch of white people there, and we'll finish with a downward dog pose. And remember to report any unattended baggage to the nearest TSA representative. Namaste, safe travels. Dude, I've been traveling around. It makes me appreciate Durango when I travel, because I went and did a gig in Pueblo, Colorado. There was a building across from the venue that said Pueblo Laser Tag and Tactical Shooting Range. Hey, be one or the other. That's so dangerous to put those right next to each other. What's going on in Pueblo? They're like, hello, thank you for calling Pueblo Daycare and Pedophile Rehabilitation Center. Hey, thank you guys for being here. That's dope that you came out, because, you know, I got a college degree and I could have got a job, but I didn't. So it's cool that you come out, because sometimes they're not people here. So it's better. It justifies not pursuing my career. Or whatever. I think the robots are coming for most of our jobs anyway. I like to tell people that, especially if they complain about their jobs. Just point out that AI could do it cheaper and faster. Like, my roommate came home from work complaining. He's like, fucking work sucked today, dude. I was like, well, if you don't want your job, we'll let the robots do it. And then he's like, a toddler, if you take a toy away, he's like, hey, no, no. Now I want it. You didn't want it a second go, yeah, but then you try to take it. And now I don't want them to have it. I think we went too far with the anti-bullying movement, because you can't even make fun of people now. And that wasn't bullying. That was important because it was a check. If you were saying dumb shit, people would make fun of you. And you'd know not to say that. And like, it used to be, if someone was like, I think the earth is flat, you'd be like, ha ha, look at Kevin, he's dumb as shit. And you beat him up. And then Kevin knows not to say that anymore. But then one day, someone stood up for Kevin, like, hey, no, Kevin's opinions matter too. And now Kevin's all confident, like, yeah, they do matter. I might run for office. And we're like, shit. I like sports, you guys. That's kind of my niche. I like to play basketball a lot. I was at the gym recently, shooting little hoops. I get challenged to a game of one-on-one. And I'm really fucking good. You know what I mean? So I'm like, kind of like, are you sure you want to play? We're gonna play to 11. I'm up 7-0. I'm like, do you want to keep going? And she's like, I'm 12. I was like, all right. I don't go easy. Why don't you raise that jump shot or I'm gonna keep blocking it. And then I lock the brakes on her wheelchair, 11-0, baby. Hold it so they know. I have a very limited skill set, so I have to take advantage of the few areas in which I excel. Basically working out and sports. Those are the skills I have. I'm in very good physical shape. You know, I work out 6 days a week. People ask me, my friends, like, how do you stay so motivated? I think for sure it's partially genetic. They say for a normal person it takes 90 days to take a behavior and turn it into a habit. Not my bloodline, okay? My dad was able to make a habit the day he started drinking, all right? I feel like if you work out, you'll have a friend that doesn't work out that tells you it's bad for you somehow. And my buddy Dave came up to me. He's like, you know, weightlifting's bad for your joints. And if you drink protein shakes, you could get kidney stones. I was like, Dave, you have a Coke habit. Thanks for the heads up, man. I'll take my chances with the kidney stones. You're a drug addict. He also formed the habit in less than 90 days. Strong bloodline. I also realize how mediocre of a skill set working out is. I go to the gym hours a day, basically, so something moderately heavy falls over, and that's where I excel. That's, oh, whoa, hey, I got it. No, I got it. This is less than I deadlift this morning at the gym. What's up? Like 325 max, did you have? Just put it over here? Okay. Late. Something heavier falls over, you let me know, all right? I was a really small kid. I was actually pretty self-conscious about my size. I weighed 120 pounds when I graduated high school. I could, like, hide behind this mic stand. I was so skinny at the time if I needed to. My sister could beat me up easily until I was 16. So when I went to college, I started lifting weights because I was self-conscious, got stronger, and now finally I can beat up my sister. It was for girls, too. I thought I would start to gain the attention of women if I started lifting weights. I was terrible with women in high school. Like, I remember being 16, I couldn't talk to girls at all until we started drinking a little bit. Then we'd start to get the confidence to talk to women. I remember being at a party with my friends, and we're getting a little drunk, and we're like, oh, dude, we should talk to girls. Like, how do you think we should do that? One of my buddies was like, just be honest and say what's on your mind. Not if you're 16, never do either of those. That's actually a good way to figure out what not to say. Think that, anything else is good. But it's the best we had to work with at the time. So I remember getting a little drunk. I was talking to a girl who I thought was out of my league, and she was like, hey, I think you're kind of cute. I was like, oh shit, this is my chance to do that, you know, say what's on my mind, be honest with this girl. I was like, I think your older sister has great boobs. So, I thought that lifting weights was the way to get girls. And I would like admire a guy at the gym with a good physique because I thought he'd be able to get a lot of girls. Like a guy with big shoulders. I'd be like, look at his shoulders. I bet girls are super into that guy's shoulders. Or if I saw a guy at the gym with like six pack abs, I'd be like, look at this six pack. I bet girls super into this six pack. Or in the locker room, I'd be like, look at this guy's dick. I bet girls are so into this guy's dick. And I was like, you know what? Now that I think about it, I might be into this dude's dick. It turns out I was. Turns out I came out as bi like 2 years ago now. So that's, yeah, it's nice being bi because I could hook up with any one of you, you know? But a crowd this size, you'll probably get someone who's like, well, actually I identify as a helicopter, so. And to them I say, I'll probably hook up with you too. I love to see them get offended and leave, like, oh, we're leaving. I love if it took a second for them to warm up, too. They're like, getting out of here. Womp, womp, womp. Close out our tab. I don't know. I don't seem gay, and that's because you can't tell how many dicks someone sucked just by looking at them. You know? And I think if you could, we'd learn things about people we're here with tonight. Probably Wes Stein, to be honest. He had a pretty accurate description of that whole meat thing. I don't know, I had a guy actually come up to me after a show. He's like, you don't seem gay. I was like, what do I do with that? Thank you, I think. I don't know. So I called him gay, is what I like to do. I was like, oh, you're gay. And he got all mad. He's like, I'm not gay. And I was like, you're being a cocksucker, so. Dude, it's funny how much straight dudes hate being called gay, because it doesn't work the other way at all. If you call it like a gay dude, you call him straight, if you're like, where's your girlfriend? They won't get mad. They'll be like, oh, sweetie. They own their shit. They're secure in who they are, at least. Do you remember I was talking to my best friend? I had to come out to him, and we started having a conversation about sexuality. And he was like, I could never be gay because I just love pussy so much. I was like, I can't see how you think that, man. Just because you love chocolate chip cookies doesn't mean you could never eat an oatmeal raisin cookie out of a dude's ass. You know what I mean, dude? Hey, thank you so much, Drago. My name's Elliot Weber.